back in the red, boo.
Back in the saddle.
Yep. And it was so different hopping in between each cow. It's good to be back.
Mad Mike feels every single adjustment that we do to the car to make it better. And he's just doing a really good job on the controls, making it look good.
He wins before he shows up because he's already gained all the fans' respect. Other drivers like him, he's a likable dude, and he's always having fun, which is rare nowadays.
The sport keeps evolving and just getting greater and faster and more radical every year that, you really got to stay on your toes to stay ahead of the power curve. So it takes a lot of guts to come back after 5 years and jump right in with the competition level that it is. But no, Mad Mike's definitely one of the top tier drivers out here. And he's got a good shot at winning.
He's truly an ambassador of drifting overall. Wanting to come over to the States, competing in Formula Drift, and campaigning a vehicle that really speaks highly of who he is, because it style-wise it exudes his passion, his style with camouflage and flares and deep dish and all this. But then now he's taken to the next level from a performance standpoint.
Rad Bull and all the equipment in it, on it, it's basically, it's got what it takes to compete and be competitive.
Okay, so yesterday in qualifying, we have two passes. Just before qualifying, the rain came down. We managed to be able to quickly change the setup. So Scott and they opened up the KW suspension, softened everything up. We let a lot of air out of the NTO5 tyres just to get as much grip as we can in the wet. So the first pass was 100%, whole track was drenched. So for my second round, I came in, we treated it as a 100% dry course. I attacked it, maximum attack the entire way around the bank, but I could feel I was maybe, you know, half a meter off. What the thing with the MX5, with such short overhang, my wheels go where no one else's go. So for me to get up onto the wall, it was actually still wet. And as I came around here at high speed and went from the dry onto the wet, it just slid us straight into the wall. So I managed to hit it a bit harder than anticipated, which straightened me out, which gave me a zero. It's been really challenging over the last couple of days with the weather. So we had a real solid setup for when it was dry. Car was super fast. And now, you know, with this weather conditions yesterday and this morning with the rain coming down, man, the track turned into like an ice skating rink. And unfortunately we blew a diff like just before top 32. The guys got the spare, pulled everything out, did an amazing job to get us down with literally minutes to go before top 32 battle against Forrest Wang. The battle against Forrest is probably the hardest I've had to fight in my drifting career.
We'll be right back.
drove like an absolute madman over the weekend. However, I think this weekend I have to give it up to my team. They did an amazing job with the tough conditions of the weather continuously changing. Every lap we were in that car, it had a different setup. It was only progressing, it was only getting faster, more responsive. And yeah, so later. Now we move on to Texas. I got to give it up to my crew. You guys were amazing this weekend. Thank you so much. Texas, here we come.